What's going on, guys? Got too much time on my hands. I'm in Reno, Nevada, and I figure I will record one more video because I went through my videos, what's already been recorded, and the most viewers I have regarding loading and unloading cattle. Mainly it's unloading, that's what I did. And a lot of people, at one point in time, when they saw a different trailer, they were asking me, is like, hey, when are you gonna have come up with more cattle videos? No more, most likely no more, unless I'm gonna help a friend of mine. I don't have a cow pot anymore, I sold it. And why was that like sort of like a temporary thing? I've been doing it, I think first time I tried it, it was four or five years ago. I helped a friend of mine, then I helped him again, then I helped him again, then it was a couple loads in a row, then like that's how I got in. I didn't got in by actually trying. It was like, I remember the first time I ever did, I actually came in, hooked up somebody else's cattle pod, they loaded on, and I took him to a slaughterhouse. I kind of didn't understand exactly what was going on. I wasn't involved in the loading, unloading. I just helped the guy out, then he called me again, then I was a little bit more involved. So things go on, and then I says, you know what, maybe I should just try it out. It's cool. But the idea was behind it, like when I started it, it wasn't like completely understanding what's going on. Maybe I think about this stuff a little too much, but when I bought my own trailer, and the first time I remember I couldn't get a load because nobody knew me. The whole trucking, the cattle hauling, it's who you know. There's no like official load board, or you can like for driving, for the example, where you can call the broker and it's like, yeah, you put 40,000 pounds of whatever Pepsi and you took off. No, the people who hiring you, they feel responsible. They want to get somebody who knows what they're doing. So if they never heard of your name, they're like, nah, not this time, man, not this time. And I made a ton of phone calls. So then I actually called a friend of mine, and he hooked me up with some people, and that's how the things take off. But anyways, did it for a little bit, kind of hit and miss with my own trailer. And then in North Platte, a couple years ago, North Platte, Nebraska, heading eastbound, got in a snowstorm and a truck passed me. I think I have a video regarding this, and a truck passed me, and it completely wiped out. It wiped me out. Like I couldn't see nothing. Like felt like I was flying through the space. And I crossed the media, and I ended up going on an incoming lane in the middle of night, like 2-3 o'clock in the morning. And luckily nobody was coming, and the ground was frozen and very little of snow on it. So if you know what I'm talking about, between the in North Platte up there, the dip in the media, like almost like none, it's basically flat. But when I come out of the blizzard with the truck picked up, I'm like, ooh, I didn't roll over, it woke me up. I'm not gonna lie, I was tired, and we were going to Lexington, Nebraska. I was almost there, and I ran with the other guy, and I called him. I says, hey, wait out for me, like I gotta check, make sure none of them fall down. So I crossed the media back on my lane, and we stop at the ramp, and I climb on the trailer. Nope, they all standing up, and they all standing up, and I'm like, I got him back, and we went in to get unloaded, and then I got to the truck stop, and I'm sitting and thinking, I was like, Jesus, if that would happen anywhere else, I could roll over it, I could kill cattle, and I potentially could kill myself too. I mean, it is dangerous. It's like there was not a perfect weather to driving at that point in time, and I put myself in positions like, okay, if I didn't have a four-legged friends back there, I wouldn't go. Like I would stop and I would sit till weather gets better, or wait till the morning, or I would play out a little more safer. With cattle, especially old cattle, old cows, mamas. The guy who hold it with it, he called them mamas. They old, so they kind of on the edge of a life, I would say. And you trying to load them up and haul them out, and Like, you're done. Because if they get, if something happens with them, not every slaughterhouse will take them. So you're most likely going to have to unload the livable, the one, the alive, and then the ones can't get up or they're dead, you have to take them somewhere. So it becomes a hassle. You kind of don't want to put yourself in that position, not creating yourself a problem. So you end up literally driving faster. You end up hammering through any kind of weather. That's why you see snowstorm, raining, sunshine. The cattle truck always has to go, unless the interstate completely closed. And though I seen the guys who actually take a secondary road and go, which you put your life in so much risk. More than anything, like, I wasn't thinking about myself, and it's truly at my bottom of my heart. I'm not trying to pretend like I'm a cool guy or anything. I'm kind of soft-hearted in certain situation. Like, I felt bad for the cattle. For me, anytime they move them in a trailer, they make them to do the things they didn't want to do, to shove them in a trailer, then you got to do countdown, break them down, stuff like that. You got to put on the nose so many, then on the belly, on the top, on the, in a jail, which I never used the jail, and then in the back. And you always, at least to me, like, I always spread them out so they have enough room, but at the same time, not too much room so they don't can't move around, because it's hard to drive with them because they move you around. And when you didn't do that job for long enough, it's hard to orientate, like looking on the animal and it's like, okay, how many can do I have to put on the nose, or how many I have to put in the belly, put on the top or in the back. So all that, it's kind of calculates everything in. And then a few times I made a mistake. I put too much on the belly, which they were really, really tight, like a sardines. And then they were too loose on the top. And then you end up unloading in because you feel bad. And everything, like, for me, was more like emotional deal. Because once again, I felt bad for them because it's livable. The freight is alive. It has the feelings. Like, I never used hot shot. If I do push him up on a trailer, it's, I mean, I buzz him maybe one time, but I see people buzzing him too many times, and I get aggravated, and especially when I, on the sale barns. I mean, in the western part of Nebraska, I was on a sale barn. I almost got in a fist fight with a guy because I stood in line, and the idea is to help somebody to load, like, you help them to load it, cattle, and they will help you. But the people at the sale barn, because they deal with them every single day, not every single day, they deal with so much volume of their livestock, they get frustrated with them, and they really, like, they don't give a shit about the abusement or anything like that. And I get so pissed off over it, and I says, hey buddy, you need to let off, don't mind your own business. And then the words keep going back and forth to the F words, and then it's like, you mother this, and I almost got kicked out of the sale barn. And the reason everything started, because I felt like the animal got abused. I actually got to that point, I'm not going to lie. I called the Nebraska Cattlemen Association and says, this and this sale barn is just absolutely abusing a hot shot, because that is insane. Some places, they don't let you use a hot shot. I actually have a hot shot underneath my bunks. And all this combined together, the more you're hauling, the more experience you end up having, you understand it's like, this job is not for me. So I end up literally parked the trailer, put it for sale. It took me a while to sell it, but then I ended up giving it. And then I hauled somebody else's guy's trailer. And the more I was doing it, it's fun. Don't get me wrong. It's cool. It's 24-hour operation and all in this. But it just, the physical part of it and a mental part of it, which is the biggest, the game was for me, to see you put yourself in danger to be in a trailer. Like, that thing happened with me and Skyler. I actually have that video. I didn't take that serious. And then I had a load of feeders, but they were massive. I don't know how they called them, feeders. And I brought them to the feedlot. I believe, I don't remember exactly what it was, but I want to say it was our lazy K. So somebody hauls the cattle, they know what I'm talking about. And my counterbalance wouldn't open. I'm going more in details, but my counterbalance wouldn't open, and I was jumping on it. Guess what? The counterbalance finally opened, and I fold in the nose of the trailer, and I had four or five a massive steers, man. Dude, I shoot out of there like a firework. Like, I literally just grabbed it with my hands, with my toes and everything. I just ran out of there so fast because it caught me off guard. I wasn't ready. And I said, you know what? I unload those steers and I said, F this. This is too dangerous. And I thought to myself, if I would got stepped on or I got, you know, they would push me with their nose or something like that. There's nobody around. It's middle of night. Like, you can get hurt so bad. And then somebody sent me a link where there's a kid got killed in the trailer hauling bulls. And I said, dude, the money's first part. It's like just not worth it. A lot of people think they pay, getting paid up the ass. No, you're dealing with a farming deal. It's all on the market. Sometimes it pays good, sometimes it doesn't. But I just understood how much risk I'm taking for no effing reason. Like, I enjoy it, but not that much to get hurt because I got a wife and a kid. So the guys who are actually doing it and who's going to watch this video, they probably going to say, well, it's not that bad. Look, if you have more experience and you probably start up a hell of a lot early, for me, the hauling cattle, it's completely different level of trucking. And sometimes I think you got to be complete nuts to do that. And with all due respect, anybody who hauls cattle, I take my hat in front of you guys. Because I know the guy's been doing it for 20 years and they kind of go with it. Maybe I over-exaggerating or whatever you want to call it. But that's how I felt regarding hauling cattle. So at this point in time, I have no trailer, no desire. Once in a while, it's like, oh yeah, it'd be cool to go haul cattle. Maybe here and there, one load or two, but on a long trips or like, no, not me. Like, now when I done it, I looked on the any kind of other type of trailer, any kind of type of freight, is just like, dude, this is easy. Like, this is nothing. And though there, you get bumps throughout the road or some things get tough to load and secure them, get dirty and stuff like that, but there's nothing compared like hauling the livestock. Not going to talk about the pigs or any other livestock. I'm talking about specifically cattle. Pigs, the reason I never did pigs, and though I had offers on it, I can't stand the smell of it. And though one time I was talking to the guy, actually, I was thinking to set myself up. My trailer actually had, it was a hog friendly. There's different trailers for people who don't know what I'm talking about. There's not every cattle pod can take hogs. They can, but you're not going to load enough. And not every hog trailer can take certain cattles either. So mine was like a straight two deck, my personal trailer. And the pigs, the smell of it, like, I'm allergic or what, but like, I don't even eat pork right now. Once in a while, don't tell me it's a pork, I will eat it. But one time I was in whatever they raised the little ones, ugh, the smell is absolutely crazy how bad they stink. Some guys who are doing it for long enough, they're like, oh, it's not that bad. For me, it was just my eyes were watering, the nose dripping, and I couldn't even stand there. Cattle, no, it doesn't bug me. So it's more of like a emotional thing for me, was in an animal abuse. And apparently I'm a little too hard, like soft, or whatever you want to call me, but that's just my personal experience hauling cattle. From try to express my from inside out. Maybe for some people they will not understand what I'm talking about, but in my opinion, if you even thinking about the hauling cattle, do as much as research you can do. And then if that doesn't like turn you away from that, go try it. Like, but don't, I wouldn't run in and buy my own trailer and it's like, yeah, I'm gonna be a cattle hauler. Like, dude, you might gonna regret on halfway in your trip. Like, for me, I tried it, I had fun with it. I can say I have experience, very little, but I have experience. And I understood it's not my thing. That's not something I can do full time. But I can go on and go on and go on. And once again, I will take my imaginary hat and the people who actually hauling cattle full time. You guys deserve a ton of respect. Because now, at the dinner, eating steak, and understanding what it's coming from, the steak tastes now completely different before I hold the cattle and after when I hold the cattle, like straight up, like to that point, how much work, sweat, the feeding, the hauling, to put it in that piece of meat, and what the animal went through, which maybe I'm exaggerating again, but that's my understanding. I didn't become a vegetarian by all means and shape. Like I said, in a couple of my videos, when I load him, he says, we're going to feed you and then we're going to eat you. And that is reality of hauling cattle. Thanks for watching all. Have a blessed one. Stay safe and keep the dirty side down.